I'm going to show you a little bit of a trick. Take a piece of tape. Your package came with thermoflow ducting. The package also came with high quality chrome ducting tape. So we sell the tent with two different air cooled package options. One is with the cool tube, which is a glass tube with the batwing reflector on top. And the second was with the luminaire, whether it's a 6-inch or 8-inch. I'm going to go ahead and set up this tent package with a 6-inch luminaire and the 6-inch cool tube. And I'm going to duct it to give you an idea how you should be air cooling and setting up your fan and filter with this grow tent package. Now there's rope ratchets that come with the package for easy hanging of the reflectors. If you've ever used chain or string before, you'll notice that these rope ratchets make it really easy to raise and lower your reflectors. Cool tube actually clips right in. There's your cool tube. There's your 6-inch. There's your 6-inch cool tube. And here's the Luminaire 6 air cooled reflector. So here we have both of our air-cooled options for our grow tent packages. We have our cool tube right here, and we have our Luminaire 6 right here. So when you're running the cord outside the tent, it's always good to hook it around some of the poles. That way, you're not having to use zip ties to clean up your power lines. Just send them right out and have the poles holding them in place. Of course, you want to use one of the plug outlets in the side of the tent. And for this configuration, we're using the outlet right here. Of course, you can configure these in many different ways. I'm just showing you one of the ways to configure it. And again, with this, we're just going to hook the power cord around so it cleans it up a little bit. It's not hanging down too far where it gets in the way. And then send this plug also outside the tent through the same plug outlet. Now to air cool these, we obviously need to connect them with ducting. And you want to give yourself a little bit so they can independently be at two heights. So you want to give yourself a little bit of slack on the ducting when you're cutting it. If you bought the cool tube package, you get two of these. If you bought the luminaire package, you get two luminaires. Go ahead and put our bulbs in. Whenever you screw a bulb in, you of course want to wipe it off afterwards to get any excess oil from your hands or any dust that's been collecting on the bulb off of it. Here's where our duct line's coming into the tent. We're going to go ahead and hook that up. So the organic air filters or the dust rooms work excellent to keep the dust from coming in the air line. We might send you a light timer like this or a light timer like this. Each of these light timers can run one 1,000 watt light or one 600 watt light. So here we've set up our air-cooled package. We have the air sucking in from this side right here. Air's moving in this line. And now we're also showing you the cool tube in operations, just so you can get an idea of both. Both the cool tube and the luminaire can be set up the same way. Air just sucks on through this light, out the tent, and we'll show you what it's doing from the other side. So here's the other side.
So the air was moving through the tent, it's moving out of the tent, it's being sucked in by the fan, down and out through the filter and being filtered out into this area. It's a great way to set up your tent, especially if you have limited space inside for the filter. Listen to this fan. This is the 6-inch fan, the value line in operation. It's pretty quiet. It's on full speed right now. Of course, the larger packages come with this dimmer, so you can go ahead and control the fan speed. Right now, I'm putting it on the variable setting so we can see it in operation. We'll go ahead and put it on low. As you can hear, the fan's just barely moving in medium and high. There's medium again. And then the full 100% power. Now say you're putting supplemental CO2 in the tent, you might want to slow the fan down to be able to allow the CO2 to build up in the tent. Or if you're propagating in the tent, you obviously want a higher humidity level and you can decrease the fan speed to build up humidity in the tent. You can also control the temperature by controlling the airflow as well. So it's a simple control that gives you the ability to control the output of the air outtake. The speedster, the fan, the filter, the ducting, the tape, and the reflectors all come with the grow tent, including the timer for this package comes with 2 grow lights. And the timer for the grow lights. Here's the front of the tent in operation. We're showing you the cool tube package right here. And then the luminaire package. It's right here. So here's the inside of our air-cooled grow room package. And let's go ahead and show you another way to mount the carbon filter.
With each package comes an Australian Virgin Premium carbon filter. These filters are good for up to 3 years, and it has the highest quality of carbon out there. This is very similar to a couple other brands out there you've heard of, the Dragon Filter, the Fresh Filter. This is almost identical, but a lot better price. So just go ahead and put the straps that come with the tent in place first. And clamp.
And there we have it. So basically we have the air being sucked in through the filter. It's being carbon scrubbed. It's moving through this reflector, through this other reflector, then out of the tent through the top right here. And you can always, of course, have it come out the side right here if that was easier for you. We just did the top because that's how we had it set up. And then let's show you the back side. The ballast. And here's our fan. So of course, the air is moving down and out through the fan, and it's been carbon scrubbed inside the tent. Now you can of course put another piece of ducting on the end of this fan and run it maybe out to a vented hole underneath your house, in through your attic and out. And again, this package is sold with the Speedster speed controller, so you can control the fan speed. This gives you a little more control over your environment. You can slow it down to
get our value line fan, our quantum ballast. Now, of course, your quantum ballast can be mounted in a lot of different places. You might have a workbench. It can actually even be mounted to the ceiling if you're in your garage. It can be mounted to the wall if you're in a room or even in the garage. So really, with these mounting keyholes, you can pretty much mount this ballast anywhere. Of course, you want to make sure the dimmer function is accessible to how you're mounting it. So if you're mounting it vertically, you want it to be on the bottom.
So here we've set up the tent with 2 4x8 trays in here with 2 reservoirs, just to show you how much equipment we can fit inside this tent. This is the DR300W, the 5x10 tent. You could of course put 1 4x8 and 1 reservoir in it as well. The grow room packages we sell is essentially just the tent with ventilation and lighting capability. The ventilation comes with a dimmer function, so you can speed up or slow down the air moving in or out of the tent. But you can choose the system to put inside. We have many products online. We have aeroponics, DWC, ebb and flow buckets, as well as a system such as this, an ebb and flow tray that you can put inside these tents.